Hey guys, I'm here again, this time to bring you my top 5 worst Mega Evolutions. And yes, this is my opinion, not official in any way, so let's get to it. Number 5, Mega Venusaur. When Mega Venusaur was revealed, I laughed. Not like that, but I laughed. I looked up reactions on various sites to see what everyone else thought of this thing, and noticed they were laughing too. I laughed a bit more, and then I realized that Mega Venusaur has more going on for it than at first glance, and that it does not take much for me to laugh. For starters, the flower on Venusaur's back has grown larger, taller, and more vibrant. There are vines that are attached to the flower and Venusaur. It does not look apparent where the vines begin and end. And the leaves around the flower on regular Venusaur have also risen with the flower, leaving blue-colored leaves on Venusaur's back. It may not be the case, but Venusaur appears to have been lightened in color. What is the case is that Venusaur has been adorned with a cute pink flower on the forehead, which really ties this mega together. Not much difference at first glance, but noticeable differences from the original design once you begin to dig a little bit deeper. Still though, Mega Venusaur is not too easy on the eyes. Number 4, Mega Gardevoir. Lady Gardevoir got a Mega Evolution. Well, so did Gentleman Gardevoir, and it gave her a crinoline. Oh yeah, Gardevoir, Mega or not, is also now part fairy, appropriate for a lady with such grace. Sorry about that, male Gardevoir. Yet the crinoline is really the only thing that pops out in this Mega Evolution. Gardevoir's arms become wide as to appear like fanciful gloves, and the chest spike opens up ever so slightly to have two spikes. That's pretty much it. Oh, and a slight haircut. There's not much more going on with Gardevoir than that. This Mega Evolution is the definition of meh for me. Number 3. Mega Aerodactyl. So, yeah, let's begin where everything went wrong with this Mega Evolution. The fingers on Mega Aerodactyl actually look dangerous, and the spikes along the tail slash back are fitting. But what is going on with that ghastly beard, and those horns on the side of the face? Seriously, did Game Freak take one look at Flixo and say, "That's what we want Mega Aerodactyl to look like"? It just does not appear that much thought was put into Mega Aerodactyl, because it's just a regular Aerodactyl with paler skin and black stones all over its body, which does not seem to fit in my opinion. Mega Aerodactyl was a big disappointment for me personally, also because I like the first generation, and it could have had a better design than this bearded mess. Number 2. Mega Manectric. Manectric is an electric type. Where did you get that idea? It's not the giant lightning bolt on its back that gave it away, is it? Manectric is the version exclusive counter to Houndoom. Mega Manectric is a moving lightning bolt with horns. It appears to be extremely top heavy and seemingly would topple over with even the slightest push. It is necessarily a bad design, just one that is not practical for a creature that needs to battle other creatures. How can Mega Manectric move gracefully without tumbling? The hips of Mega Manectric have now become ripe with blue fur instead of yellow spiky hips, and the claws of Mega Manectric have become red like the blood it seeks. Still, I just cannot get past this Mega Evolution, because it's essentially, let's take an electric type Pokemon and turn it into a lightning bolt. Or, let's take this electric Pokemon and turn it into an ugly creature deliberately just to piss off the fans. Even better idea? Let's just put a lightning bolt on the Pokemon. Brilliant. What really saddens me though about the development of this Mega Evolution is how proud and graceful Manectric looks in its non-evolved form. In its evolved Mega Evolution, it looks like a timid, pathetic little rat. And I just don't see how that's an improvement or an evolution whatsoever. Number 1. Mega Mewtwo X and Y. Mewtwo, said to be the strongest Pokemon ever before they decided to add Arceus, is already badass in itself, and is also one of my favorite Pokemon. Giving Mewtwo one Mega Evolution is one thing, but giving it Mega Evolutions is kind of an insult to me, but mostly to Mewtwo. Mewtwo does not need any sort of evolution in the first place, especially not to make it stronger than what it already is. Giving Mewtwo an evolution implies that it needs to be stronger. And so, Game Freak decided to add these silly-looking plastic figurines that looks like incomplete pre-evolutions of non-legendary Pokémon. It would be alright if they looked remotely stronger or cooler, but they don't. They don't at all. I think it's a disgrace. What do you guys think?